Yo, welcome to a new edition of the Lamont Experience. I'm Lamont, and these are my experiences. My guest today, very good friend, one of the funniest comedians in the world. She is hilarious. She's been on Conan. She's been on Late Night with Seth Meyers. She has an album out called The Grudgery. My guest today, the fabulous Erin Jackson. What's up, Erin?
What up? What up? Long time no see.
Oh, it's been a How long? It's been forever since I've seen you. I mean, I've seen you on the internet, like Twitter and stuff. You know, so we communicate occasionally, but at a comedy show, it's been a long time.
Mm-hmm.
You've been busy. You've been doing your thing, and we were joking about this before we started recording, but like I made the mistake of asking you what you wanted to talk about. You cussed my ass out.
I didn't cuss you out, but you were like, let me know what you want to talk about. Let me know. I was like, you invited me on your podcast. You must have something to ask me.
Well, I mean, you know what I'm saying. There's some things that people might, I'd be like, yo, what about that time? And you'd be like, wait, whoa, I thought, you know, like, you never know what people don't want to touch on. Plus, I think our thing, like, you're a Philadelphia Eagles fan, right?
I am.
And I am a New England Patriots fan. So
we both are having a bad year.
We are like water and oil mixing. We are having a terrible year. Normal year for y'all, really, but for us, it's a terrible year.
Are you gonna? Did you forget the year that we beat you in the Super Bowl? That was a pretty good year.
I remember the year we handed y'all the key to the Super Bowl, and I want to say congratulations. You're welcome. We didn't feel like it that year. We were just like, you know what? We might as well let somebody else keeps the championship.
Well, this has been fun, Lamont. Thanks for having me. And I hope you've enjoyed this chat.
Well, I know, but listen, I rock with Philly, though. I rock with Philly. Y'all gave us the Roots. I'm saying, y'all just gave us the White House. So I rock with Philly, man. I think that both cities have aggressive nations. And so sometimes, we can go head to head. We go, you know, on that whole thing.
Well, now I'm not from Philly, though.
Okay.
I'm from Jersey, but my dad's from South Jersey, so I grew up kind of like in the middle. My dad's from Camden, which is like right over the water from Philly, but I didn't grow up in Philly, so that's not like it's my city, but it's not my city.
Yeah. So, do you root for all the Philly sports teams?
I root for the Eagles. Put it like that.
Okay.
I'm a Knicks fan when it comes to basketball. I know. I just chose a hard life, Lamont, is what I'm saying.
Why would you do that to yourself?
I mean, look, it was established when I was young.
They like we out here having parades for Celtics every year, so I can't even talk shit about that. But I mean, I'll spare you the time of sports. I'll spare you all that. So let's talk about
I like sports, but you know, every year the Knicks have this high hopes, like, oh, we're going to get CP3. We're not going to get anybody. Nobody wants to play in New York, which makes me so sad. Because people should want to play in the Garden?
You know why? Because you have an owner.
The worst owner.
The owner sucks. And until he sells that team or is forced to sell that team, I don't know what y'all going
to
do.
I'm trying to trade him.
Yeah, all right, so you got to just do something about that owner, Erin. He's got to go because he's weighing your whole team down and the whole city and your whole region. And you got to just pick better sports teams. I'm just going to be honest with you.
Well, you pick who you pick and you stick with them. Like, I'm not going to pick another team because that's not how sports fandom works.
Fair enough.
Anybody who's listening. So those are my teams. They've been my teams. And I just got to, you know, suffer.
Well, then let's shift the conversation to something more jovial, something happy.
Okay.
The pandemic.
Oh.
How have How have you been as a, I know a lot of creatives having trouble kind of doing their thing during this thing. Like, have you gone out and performed anywhere live since March or?
I did. I think I did my very first drive-in show. I did a drive-in show in May. Because I was just itching to see what that was like. And then I sat tight until, I think, August. And I didn't feel comfortable going out. It wasn't like, I mean, I was itching to do stand-up, but I'm still very, like, wary and careful. Like, I haven't been out anywhere to eat. Really, I order in. I haven't been hanging out with people. But I taped a special for Netflix with Tiffany Haddish in October. And I was asked about it, I think, in August. So it was like, all right, I got to get out there and prep for it. I haven't done comedy in 4 or 5 months. So I started going out and doing stuff, rooftop shows and stuff like that. And, but I didn't, you know, I didn't like it. It just felt like, it's really tough. I mean, I have not been able to get past the scariness of it. You know what I mean? Some people I see out there, they're touring. I'm like, you working inside? Like, I remember back in the day when somebody used to offer me a show and I used to be like, yo, is it outside? And then they'd be like, yeah. I'd be like, nah, I'm not doing no outside shows. Now I'm like, is it inside? Oh, hell no. Like, I ain't doing no inside. So it's like everything is flipped. Like, the whole world is upside down. What about you?
Nah, listen, I feel you on that. Like, I'm terrified. Real talk. Yeah. Like, I have rarely left my block since March. I mean, it's only essentials, only if I need something. I'm not going to anybody's house. Yeah. I'm not having anybody over my house.
I haven't either.
None of that. And as far as performing, I haven't done one live show since March. Everything I've done has been virtual.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Everything I've done has been virtual. I've done some more writing. I've written some articles and stuff like that. That's kind of helping me supplement my income and that kind of thing. But no, like, I'm worried about even the smallest things. Like, I obsess over microphones. Like,
yeah, sure.
Are we going to have to start bringing our own microphones to these
things? Absolutely you do. I've been focusing on the writing too. Like, if I hadn't had to do that taping live, I would not have been out live, and I'm done. I'm not doing anything else. Now I have one event on Friday, which isn't really stand up, but it's an event that I'm doing in a very tight space, like a very enclosed space with a few people. And I'm just kind of hosting a live event, and everybody's getting tested, you know, as we go on there and all that stuff. But that's the last thing I'm doing till it's warm again. And hopefully, you know, maybe we'll be seeing, you know, a possible end to it. I don't miss stand up that much to where I'm like, you know, these Zoom shows are good. I'm getting my writing done. It's good.
Go out there. I say yes to one gig, and then the next day, everybody's like, "You going to Lamont's thing?" Not me. I had somebody ask me to do a music festival. This is back in June when we thought maybe this would be over in a reasonable period of time. They were like, "Can you do it in September?" And I was like, "I don't know." And they were like, "Yeah, I mean, it'll be 10 hours. You'll be the host. You know how when people don't know about comedy, they try to talk about it. And between every musical act, you'll have 15 minutes to mess with." I'm like, between all of the act, I have 15, so I can just. And they were like, so we were thinking $250 would be fair. And I would have to leave the state.
Phones don't even do this anymore, but click.
Yo.
Nah.
He was like, why are you laughing at me?
Because you a comedian, you should just host it yourself.
You need to do that's mad funny. Player.
That's mad funny.
So they were like, he was like, I don't think they'll. I quoted him a price, and he was like, I don't think they'll go for this, but I'll get back to you.
Never heard from him again.
I haven't heard of him.
Of course.
Nah. But you've been doing stuff like, I've noticed on your Twitter, like, you do this cool thing now. I think you should make this a thing. Like, your sweater, your fashion show at the crib.
Yes.
Yeah, I've been doing it.
Well, you know what? I'm running out of sweaters. I got one more that I'm going to do, I think, this week. Last week was such a mess that, you know, with everything going on in the world, I was like, I'm just gonna take a week off. But yeah, I'm like, I do miss fall. Like I realized I didn't even, like I've been going out, I'll go to the stores, I'll go shopping, I've done stuff. But I realized I hadn't even paid attention to fall. Like I hadn't even noticed the leaves changing or whatever. Cause I go out, I come back in. Like I wasn't, you know, taking everything in. And I realized like, this is my favorite time of year. This is my favorite part of my wardrobe. Ain't nobody getting to see these sweater. I got sweater game, yo. And it's like, that's my favorite thing to do. And now I can't show them to nobody. So I started doing these sweater fashion shows at the house, putting them on Instagram. And it's fun. It makes me happy. I guess it makes other people happy. And so, yeah, I got a couple more sweaters in my bag.
I think they were cool. Like, I think they were cool. And I'm like you, I love autumn. I love mm-hmm. fall. Like it's my favorite season, and I'm not gonna front. Like I never say this publicly, but I got a couple scarves. You know what I'm saying? I got a couple scarves in the tuck. I'll be ready for it. I'm like, oh wait a minute, it might be time for this one. Yeah. Mm-mm. So I get down with that. Like I know people say, this is when I start dressing. It's like this is when I start scarving. Mm-hmm.
It's true.
I get my scarves going.
I'm like, we're gonna go through. I'm gonna miss the whole fall. It's gonna be hot again. I'm just. Yeah. So I've been trying to find little things. I've never been great at social media. And I'm like, well, now you got it. That's all you got. So I've got to learn to do more things and get better at it. And so I'm just having fun.
That's what you got to do. Like ultimately for me, obviously I've been doing a lot more Zoom stuff, mm-hmm. a lot more, any kind of show that I can, I've been trying to even seek out stuff that I could do online. Like I'm thinking about doing a Zoom, not a special, but like work on material thing and see if I can get people to kind of check it out. Cause I've gotten booked for some virtual shows that I have coming up and I kind of want to be ready. Like I've done, you know, the occasional 15 minute spot on Zoom or 20 minute spot, but I need to like, I'm doing like an hour for a thing I'm preparing for.
Oh,
so
wow.
It's been a long time since I've done even 40 minutes.
Yeah.
You know, yeah. My last live show was March 7th. And I want to be ready. And then they pay me like actual money that I need.
Right.
So
right.
I don't want to go in there and be like,
right, right.
Remember Walgreens?
Remember outside? Look,
remember that?
I've been doing, this is the thing that I've been doing. I bought all these little card games. Like One Gotta Go. Do you know what that is?
Oh, I've seen like on Twitter, they do that a lot. There'll be four items and then you right. gotta pick which one gotta, yeah, yeah, yeah.
So we'll do that like little game nights, like One Gotta Go. I got one that's the University of Hip Hop, or I think that's what it's called. And it's got all these like hip hop questions and just like throw, I should have grabbed them. But it's like, those are fun things I've been doing. This should try to, you know, have little game nights or have little fun things. Cause Lord knows I need some company in this house. It's hard being single during the pandemic, yo.
Hey, listen, you ain't gotta tell me that. It's rough out here. I mean, listen, I'm not gonna front. God. It was rough for me. It was rough for me when the streets was regular.
Usually if I'm not seeing nobody or whatever, it's like, all right, that's my fault. Like, but now I just blame it on people like in Iowa. Like I'd be like, it's your fault. You won't wear no mask. That's why I ain't got no booty. And I know that's not real, but that's how it makes me feel better. It makes me
Iowa, feel better. Get your shit together. So you know Erin can get her swerve on.
Some penis.
You be watching Friends like, oh word, Ross, you really gonna hug Rachel right now in this right. economy?
I know. It's just weird when you see crowds and stuff, and it's just like, oh yeah, people used to be together.
I was I was watching some of your comedy clips on YouTube, and then I remembered, it made me remember, I had Kelly McFarlane on a few episodes ago, mm-hmm. and we were talking about Aspen, and that's where I believe we met, mm-hmm. like 10 years ago in Aspen.
Reminiscing about road stories, who was I talking to? It doesn't matter. And I was saying how, I remember I was in Lexington, Louisville, somewhere, and at this club, and I'm a big bourbon fan. I don't know if you know that about me. Like, I love whiskey, I love bourbon. Okay. And like I've been to all the, you know, distilleries on the Bourbon Trail, all that kind of thing. And so I was at this club in Kentucky, and I had never been to Maker's Mark. And I was like, oh, I want to go to Maker's Mark. And I didn't rent a car. And I was like, who wants to take me to Maker's Mark, right? And so yes. I just wound up going to Maker's Mark with a rabbi. And like, I just picked me up the next day. And like, I took a road trip back from Montreal with five strangers because they was running out of rental cars and we all wanted to get home. So we just rode together. Like, I just love having stories.
I'm like, Aaron's Aaron's like, it ain't a trip unless I almost get kidnapped.
I mean,
that's the only way I like to travel.
Well, I made sure that everybody, like when before we got in the car, I was like, oh, we should take a picture for Instagram, like, memorializing for the gram, and took a picture. And I was like, what's everybody's tag? You know what I mean? I tagged everybody. And then I sent it to all my friends. I was like, these are the people who murdered me if something happens. But you know what I mean? Like, you gotta be safe. But I love an adventure. Like anything. You gotta go up to the mountain if you're in Aspen. Well, I'm never going back to Aspen. I don't have money for Aspen. You know what I'm saying? You gotta.
I don't trust nobody, man. I remember I went up to do Lucy Fest up in like Jamestown, New York.
Yeah,
they picked me up from the airport in Buffalo, and the drive to Jamestown from Buffalo was twice as long as the flight from Boston to Buffalo. And that's rule number one. If the drive time is double the flight time, I'm going someplace I don't need to be. And I just remember like near the hotel, there was a elementary school across the street, and then the street above it, there was a store that just said guns and ammo. Guns, letter N, ammo. And then in the front, there was like a porch style situation, there was a rocking chair with, and I don't know if this is just how I remember it, but it was like a kid, like an 8-year-old kid sitting in that rocking chair.
He was a ghost.
And I was like, I'm not leaving the hotel. I'm just gonna sleep and then do the show and then immediately scurry back to the hotel. Nope.
That place didn't seem like it was for you. Yeah, no, guns and maybe roses, but definitely not guns and ammo.
Yeah. Fuck with guns and roses, but in ammo, nah. When I go to a hotel room, I always do the full blind shut. And when I go to bed, because the sun's not telling me when to wake up, I get up when I feel like it. And then I might explore your city, but probably not.
Probably. See, I'm the opposite. Like, I feel like I've never, like, when I was on the road a lot, I didn't go anywhere exotic. Like, I wasn't, like, an international touring comic or whatever, but I've been everywhere in the United States. And
yeah,
I can't just sit in a Holiday Inn Express. Like, I used to do these travel videos called Me in Your City, where I would just find the strangest thing in the town that I was in and make a video about it. I'd be like, oh, you got a museum about what? Okay, let's go there. Let's do that. You know what I mean? Like, I can't sit in a hotel. I can't, I got to have a story from all the trips. Cause I'm like, when it's all over, I'm not going to be like, oh, I went to that town and I sat in the Ramada. I went to that town. Oh yeah. They had a very nice Holiday Inn. Like, you know what I mean? Like, I got to have stories about going wine, you know, bourbon tasting with a rabbi.
My stories are going to be wild, boring. They're going to be like, what happened, Lamar? Like, the hotel had cookies. And then I went back to sleep.
I was right near the ice machine. Like,
no. Right? Yo, I love the ice machine. Don't get me started. I love that ice machine. Well, listen, I want to say this too. I have one more question. This is goofy. I always want to know this of people. If you had the opportunity, which Sesame Street Muppet would you fist fight?
Would I fist fight?
Would you fist fight?
Oh, man. I gotta fight a Muppet. I mean, I don't really have beef with any of the Muppets. I mean, I'm serious about my food. I would fight over cookies. I mean, I could fight Cookie Monster. I don't know. is he a Muppet?
No, he's a Muppet. I mean, they're all Muppets. I mean, they just don't get labeled the Muppets because it's not on the Muppet show, but
I don't want to fight anybody. I don't know.
Elmo, you wouldn't give Elmo.
I mean, Elmo's a little annoying. I mean, you know,
you would take Elmo behind the woodshed to give him a couple rounds.
Not Elmo, but I mean, I'm not a big fan of Snuffy, but maybe, you know, but I wouldn't want to fight him. I just would.
No, nah, I wouldn't want to fight Snuffy because I don't think I could win. Now, Ernie's not enough. Ernie.
I don't even remember which one is Bert, which one is Ernie.
Ernie is the one with the rubber ducky, the orange one. And then Bert.
Who would you fight? Why are we fighting Muppets?
I would fight Ernie, first of all. Because I think Bert gets a lot of heat because they call Bert a hater because Bert's never trying to have fun and he's serious. And Ernie's just out there having fun. But like nobody pays attention to the fact that Bert's paying all the bills and Ernie's probably about 8 months to a year late on his rent. So Ernie would get these hands. No
doubt. What are you talking about? No wonder this is a cannabis podcast. Now I understand. What are you talking about? No, I don't remember. I don't remember Sesame Street that well. It sounds like you're still into it. It sounds like you're still watching.
I haven't watched Sesame Street in a long time. Although I did watch it like a couple years ago, and I was angry by all the faces I didn't recognize. Yeah. I didn't know anybody on the show. But I did watch, I found out Netflix had Sesame Street like 2 years ago, but it was leaving. So I decided to like go back and check it out. I had never seen like the first season. I'd never seen like the early years. So I watched the pilot. And if you ever get a chance to watch the pilot, it is one of the freakiest things I have ever seen. I promise you, they did not think that show was getting picked up. Because just a couple of quick bites. Big Bird is that version of Big Bird is terrifying. Oscar the Grouch is orange. And at the end of the episode, the original Gordon, there were two Gordons. Mm-hmm. The original Gordon is Holly Robinson Pete's father.
Really?
He was first Gordon.
Oh, yeah, no, I knew that.
Oh, I didn't realize that till 2 years ago. And he accuses Oscar of smoking weed at the end of the episode.
Really?
He says to this kid, he goes, "And you met Oscar, right? Remember Oscar?" And he goes, And I had to rewind it like 8 times and be like, did he really just?
I feel like so many of those shows, though, from what I do remember, like having watched or been around like my friends' kids, like that stuff, there's a lot of stuff in there for the parents that have to watch with their kids. Like it's definitely not for the kids. It's like, yo, you gonna make me watch this with you? I better enjoy it. That's hilarious. No, I do.
So we beat up Ernie and Elmo and maybe Cookie Monster. Listen.
Yeah. I don't really want to fight him up it.
Aaron, thank you so much for coming on my show. Sure. I appreciate that. Everybody check out Aaron. Go find The Grudgery. Pick that album up. She said she ain't had nothing to promote, but Netflix, you got something coming out on Netflix soon.
I don't know when it's coming out, though. So, yeah.
But we'll know. Keep an eye on Aaron Jackson, all right?
Yeah.
Follow her at, is it EJ the Comic?
EJ the Comic
on Twitter, also on Instagram?
Yes.
So follow Aaron Jackson at EJ the Comic on Instagram and on Twitter. Find out when that Netflix special is coming out. Check out The Grudgery. She's one of the funniest comedians I know and a very good friend of mine. And I thank you for being on the show with me today. Appreciate that.
Thank you.
And as always, elevate the culture. Double points. Peace.